We will now begin the funeral service for Dr. Edward Huang.
난 지금 오늘 같이 기도도 하고 문킹 박수 급에 봐.
If you're able, please stand to sing How Great Thou Art. Grant us your blessing in this hour, and enable us to put our trust in you, that our spirits may grow calm and our hearts be comforted. Lift our eyes beyond the shadows of earth and help us to see the light of eternity. So may we find grace and strength for this and every time of need, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
祈祷，主爱天父，你是创造宇宙万民真理的上帝，我要感谢你，在你的圣旨意甲了你下面，我聚集做伙，为着我所敬听的亲人朋友，吴文清博士举行告别礼拜。 恳求上帝的灵降临伫阮中间来带领，互阮逐项兴事对头到尾拢平安顺利。人生路途哪人客是暂时的，有喜乐，有苦难。感谢主，你已经替去伊人生的重担，除去病痛、烦恼、艰难，接伊转去父的厝，互伊安歇伫主的怀抱。 伫遐，甲所有听伊的人相见面。阮虽然毋甘伊离开阮，总是阮相信，暂时分开，希望将来伫天国搁再相见。天父上帝，求你的圣灵伫即个时阵扶持帮助，互阮的心灵得到平安。求你安慰伊族，搁较施恩，帮助伊族甲正兄弟姊妹会当坚强。
For the message, I'd like to share something written by Maya Angelou. She wrote, I've learned that no matter what happens or how bad it seems today, life does go on, and it will be better tomorrow. I've learned that you can tell a lot about a person by the way he or she handles these three things: a rainy day, lost luggage, and tangled Christmas tree lights. I've learned that regardless of your relationship with your parents, you'll miss them when they're gone from your life. I've learned that making a living is not the same as making a life. I've learned that life sometimes gives you a second chance. I've learned that you shouldn't go through life with a catcher's mitt on both hands. You need to be able to throw something back. I learned that whenever I decide something with an open heart, I usually make the right decision. I learned that even though I have pains, I don't have to be one. I've learned that every day you should reach out and touch someone. People love a warm hug or just a friendly pat on the back. I've learned that I still have a lot to learn. I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. When I found out that Alice would be sharing something about her grand third uncle, I asked her what she would say. Because to be honest, I do not know him. And I won't spoil what she's going to say for you. But what I gather from what she will say, what she will share, is how she felt from him. She felt loved. And this love reminds me of a poem translated by Daniel Ladinsky. What keeps us alive, what allows us to endure? I think it is the hope of loving or being loved. I heard a fable once about the sun going on a journey to find its source and how the moon wept without her lover's warm gaze. We weep when light does not reach our hearts. We wither like fields if someone close does not rain their kindness upon us. I believe you and I are created for love. I believe you and I are created to be in community, to be one another's sun, to radiate love. So the sadness is that when a person dies, we will never again feel the kindness, the love of this person upon us. What we do have is each other. What we do have is the memories of grand third uncle, who lived a long life, who loved the family, who rained his kindness upon his family members, and who I read loves dancing and celebrated life. With each day that we live, may we make others feel loved. May we rain kindness upon those who come into contact with us, as we have been loved and have been shown kindness by those who have gone before us. And may their love and kindness live on in us and to the many generations to come.
英文的人真少，所以伊人拢认为伊是一个真好的英文老师。伫1948年8月28日，伊坐船来美国，伊一只摕硕士、摕博士，最后伫纽约大学的宗教博士，伊的论文是比较宗教。最后伊伫纽泽西的大学伫遐来退休，伫1990年来退休。伊当年自费来遮留学，靠着伊的双手、伊的勤俭来拍拼。伊毋仅是干呐友好老爸老母，佫就是真正是真照顾兄弟姊妹。伊伫阮的家庭内底，伊是一位真正好的长辈，值得阮来怀念。我们金博士时常互邀请去每一个教会，伫日本人的教会，或者是幼联教会、台湾纽约教会来讲道，伊的讲道拢会当吸引人的心，互人会当感动，会当来搁较轻佻一注。但2014年正月28日，伊受主的拣召，伊放落伊的担，伊安歇伫主的内面，伊是94岁，也愿一切的荣耀拢归伫上帝。
Dr. Edward Huang was born on October 20, 1920 in Changhua, Taiwan, into a blessed Christian family. His father, Dai Chen Huang, and mother, Xianhu Huang, had 6 sons and 5 daughters. Dr. Edward Huang was the 5th child of 11 siblings. He came to the United States from Taiwan in October 1948, through the Moody Bible Institute, MBI, which inspired him to continue further his training in Columbia Bible College, New York Theological Seminary, Union Seminary, Columbia University, New School, and New York University. He received many degrees and PhD from these institutions. Simultaneously, he taught in several colleges and universities in New York and New Jersey State College, now is New Jersey City University, for 35 years. Concentrating in comparative religious, comparative philosophies, philosophy of religion, Bible theology to thousands of students. He was very fluent in Chinese, Japanese, Taiwanese, English, and German. He retired in 1990 at the age of 70. He continued to preach after retirement, gave lectures, and did many volunteer services to senior centers. He got married to Billy C. Chan, a registered nurse, on March 12, 1989, in New York City. They have no children. Dr. Howard Wang, Edward Wang, had a passion for dancing, and with his wife, Billy, are very active members of the Imperial Dance Studio. They all participated and showcased their dancing skills at numerous areas and events. They were great and wonderful as they performed, as always. God called him home in the afternoon on January 28, 2014 at 2:50 p.m. He is survived by his wife, Billy, brother, Andrew, sisters, Tongxia and Soxia, nephews and nieces, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, through his brothers and sisters. He lives as a legacy of wonderful life, very well lived, filled with much happiness, joy, and love.
Gugong was a steady presence in my life. He visited often and would chat and catch up with every family member. He had attended every family function when possible and would break out his smooth dance moves when given the opportunity. I had the honor of being the flower girl at his and Auntie Billy's wedding. It didn't quite go the way I had practiced in my basement. My stage presence was just a tad underdeveloped, and I cried my way down the aisle. And even so, he greeted me with a warm smile at the end of the aisle. Later on, when Sakugong would come to visit, he would bring roast pork buns from a specific store in Chinatown because he knew how much we loved them. Although roast pork buns could be found in many bakeries, these buns tasted better since they were always delivered with a loving heart. These memories of him will forever be remembered and cherished. The word of thanks will be given by Timothy Zhuang.
And Billy. 真感謝大家來參加我阿伯的朋友，我想要很高興他說這個話，但是聽起來說心肝很苦。I
want to thank everybody for coming to attend my Uncle Edward's funeral. I was going to make something pleasant, but I am so sad at this moment.
啊，在咱台湾人的地吼，是应当是八十岁以上，咱爱穿红纱啦，吼，应当是穿放红贴吧，因为是一个快乐的代志，因为已经一生中岁数九十四岁，应当来讲，咱是无真侪人活活到这岁，吼，我平常讲活八十多岁，真算是足有福气，属于足大的祝福。
In our culture, today is Chinese New Year, and we are supposed to be wearing red. But, you know, and also being passed away at this high age, we're supposed to be wearing red and be joyful and, you know, be happy for him. But my uncle, he lives to 94. It's a great age. My father-in-law only lived to 86, and you know, it. For my uncle, he had a very, very long life.
我阿伯吼是一个足有疼心的，咱拄则拢听到伊的历历吼，也足有疼心的。啊，伊嘛足好诶，有甲我阿姨比利结婚吼，啊，伊有甲足好诶照顾，啊，互阮阿伯伫啊晚年诶时阵有过一个真快乐诶日子。 啊，这孙啊吼，大家嘛对伊拢足友好，大家嘛甲伊足好诶，所以互伊足大诶安慰。
Okay, my uncle is very lucky to marry Billy, who is a wonderful person, also a registered nurse. I mean, how wonderful you have a private nurse in your own home, and also he has so many. I mean, everyone in this every relative in this city area is all, we all come to America because of him, and everybody is very, very close to him because he is such a wonderful person.
Ah, 对，我感觉上帝啊。 因为伊看我阿伯吼，年龄嘛有够啊，啊伫世间替伊做，伊工也有够啊，啊今仔甲带伫上帝遐，伫遐享受天堂的快乐。God
is kind to my uncle Edward because he's a wonderful person and he did so much work for God, and in this today, God released his illness and take him home. And take him to a better place where he is going to see his brothers and sisters and in a better, happier place.
Ah, 我无代表黑人，但是我占权来代表家族吼，来甲大家说多谢，感谢恁今仔日，感谢上帝，今仔日天气嘛真好，啊，感谢你今日来参加啊，我的阿伯的funeral。
I shouldn't be here because I am not in line for the higher rank in the relative position to say this word of thanks. But I am just very grateful that I'm giving this opportunity to say thank you to everybody and thank God the weather is so wonderful and thank all of you for coming to attend the funeral service of our Uncle Edward. Thank you.
If you're able, please stand for his favorite hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Even be seated.
Ago, are you big gong way about?
I am.
阿哥，你真伟大耶！
Thank you.
Yes, you can take with you. Yes.
Thank you.
Resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though he dies, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother, Dr. Edward Huang. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. We now commit Edward's body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. O God, make us deeply aware of the shortness and uncertainty of our human life. Raise us from sin into love and goodness. Support us all the day long of our troubled life until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest, and peace at the last, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I thought it would be fitting to sing his favorite hymn one more time. I don't know how many of you have programmed, but hopefully we all know the first verse, at least. It is What a Friend We Had in Jesus.
Oh, we left it in the car.
Shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face to you and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Let us do one more time to remember and respect Dr. Edward Huang. And I was told we will be putting flowers in the front of the picture.